Okay, let's just say for a minute that you're trying to learn how to differentiate between different species of penguins. And bear with me, this is going somewhere, I promise. And so you're trying to figure out the best way to study so that when you see a given penguin, you're able to go, aha, that is definitely Alakesis. So there's a couple of options, right? Option number one involves you taking one penguin at a time, learning its characteristics, seeing a lot of images about it, and then moving on to the next and repeating this process over and over again. One penguin at a time until you've seen a bunch of images from a bunch of species, one after another. Option number two is not to study one species at a time, but instead to do rounds of seeing just one picture from multiple species and then a second round or multiple rounds of just one picture from every species until you've reviewed the same number of images as with the first method. So the question is, which study method would you choose? Well, the researchers that performed this very same study thought that most people would prefer and perform better when thoroughly studying one penguin species at a time, or as they like to call it, studying in block. After all, that is what makes the most sense and goes according to this common mantra of taking one problem at a time, learning it comprehensively, and then moving on to the next. The thing is, however, that the actual results came out to be the total opposite. The students that learned the material through the second method, which they like to call spaced or interleaved, outperformed the ones who studied in block in every single test. And the cool thing is that those results were not only manifested between groups, but within the same person. So if you take a given student and make him study half of the penguins in block and the other half is spaced out, his performance on the spaced out penguins will be 30% higher or better than on the species he learned in block. So I really encourage you to ponder on how you actually study. Do you take one topic at a time and comprehensively learn it? Or are you more in the camp of spacing out the learning how this study proposes you should study? And before you start going with the whole, oh, but that is with penguins, that doesn't apply to real subjects like mathematics or medicine, take into account that these results have been replicated in studies across all kinds of fields and topics like paintings, music, voices, etc. And the result is always the same. Studying just bits of information from multiple topics in multiple rounds beats studying single topics thoroughly and comprehensively one at a time. And as far as we can tell, this applies to all sorts of fields like biology, psychology, languages, and even medicine. After all, regardless of what you happen to study, what you're truly trying to learn are patterns. And in the exact same way a biology student learns to differentiate seven different species of penguins that are all black with an orange beak, a medical student learns to differentiate seven different diseases that all present with chest pain and dyspnea. Because in the end, everything boils down again to just patterns of information. But here's the really interesting part. If you ask the students in each of these studies after performing the test which method they think is best for maximizing learning and performance, 90% of the times they will say that studying in block is best. And even if you tell them that 90% of learners perform better with the spaced out method, 80% of them will still tell you that they belong to the 10% that don't. So a couple of take home messages from this study. First, when studying for an exam, and in general when studying anything, try to space out your learning so that you don't review one subject at a time, very comprehensively, very in depth, but instead beat some pieces of the whole subject from multiple subjects and to do that in multiple rounds. For instance, what a medical student might do is instead of trying to study one disease at a time, trying to learn everything about it very comprehensively, you know, pathophysiology, presentation, diagnosis, treatment, he would instead have multiple rounds where he learns not a, well, just a component, but not of one, but multiple diseases at a time. So one round where he reviews the clinical presentation of a few diseases, another where he learns the pathophysiology, another where he learns the treatment, and so on and so forth. That is actually what I did when I studied for the United States Medical Licensing Examination, which is one of the toughest exams med students ever take. I pretty much based my whole study using this method of using question banks as my primary resource. And the thing you know you have to know about question banks is that they kind of force you to approach multiple subjects at the same time in each question. And you have to focus on a specific thing across all of them. And each time you review a new question, a new perspective about a new or another set of diseases comes up. Which is in a sense exactly what this study shows is a better strategy to learn. The second take-home message is best put by Richard Feynman. The first rule is that you must not fool yourself and that you're the easiest person to fool. So just remember, most people thought studying in block was better even after performing the test. That goes to show you that our intuition and knowledge about effective study strategies is deeply biased and flawed. Who knows how many ineffective study methods we continue to keep around just because they feel intuitive or easier. And by that same token, who knows how better your performance could get if only you gave yourself the opportunity to try out counterintuitive but proved to be effective methods. But anyhow, if you like this video and want to continue learning, I really encourage you to use the link I have in the description and start your 1 month free trial of Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning platform that has a bunch of classes on a myriad of topics like learning, productivity, lifestyle, pretty much anything you can imagine really. For instance, just last week I watched a class about the fundamentals of web typography by Jason Santamaria, and you know, I learned a lot of stuff like how to select a legible font, difference between legibility and readability, and a lot of really useful concepts for my videos and thumbnails. And I reckon you may not necessarily be that much into typography, but the reason I'm mentioning this is because just as I discovered a class that was useful to me, I'm sure you can also find classes that teach you stuff you actually want and need to learn. And the great thing about Skillshare is that it was built with learning in mind. So it doesn't have ads interrupting you every 5 minutes, the classes are very concise, they really go to the point, they leave you take home messages, and also leave you projects to put in practice exactly what you learn. It's really an amazing platform. And so yeah, if you wanna check it out for yourself, there's a link in the description with 1 month free trial waiting for the first 1,000 subscribers to use it. So hey, why not start exploring your creativity today? But anyways, huge thanks to Skillshare for sponsoring this video, to you for tuning in, and as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.